There are a few more seats here in front of the altar if you want to sit down. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good morning to you all, and you are all welcome to the Mass. Let us offer this Mass for Brian Conlon, John and Julia McShane, Dennis and Molly Doyle, Huey and Seamus Riley, John Rafferty and his daughter Teresa and deceased family members, Veronica Shields and Jerry Rowland. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon them, and may they rest in peace. Amen. Brothers and sisters, to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart, Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners, Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us, Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, that we may always revere and love your holy name, for you never deprive of your guidance those you set firm on the foundation of your love. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
The first reading, a reading from the book of Job. From the heart of tempest, the Lord gave Job his answer. He said, "Who pent up the sea behind closed doors, when it leapt tumultuous out of the womb, when I wrapped it in a robe of mist and made black clouds its swaddling bands? When I marked the bounds it was not to cross and made it fast with a bolted gate. Come thus far, I said, and no farther. Here your proud waves shall break." The word of the Lord. Responsorial Psalm. O give thanks to the Lord, for his love endures forever. O give thanks to the Lord, for his love endures forever. Some sail to the sea in ships to trade on the mighty waters. These men have seen the Lord's deeds, the wonders he does in the deep. O give thanks to the Lord, for his love endures forever. For he spoke, he summoned the gale, tossing the waves of the sea. Up to heaven and back into the deep, their soul melted away in their distress. O give thanks to the Lord, for his love endures forever. Then they cried to the Lord in their need, and he rescued them from their distress. He stilled the storm to a whisper, All the waves of the sea were hushed. O give thanks to the Lord, for his love endures forever. They rejoiced because of the calm, and he led them to the haven they desired. Let them thank the Lord for his love, the wonders he does for men. O give thanks to the Lord, for his love endures forever. The second reading, a reading from St. Paul's second letter to the Corinthians. The love of Christ overwhelms us when we reflect that if one man has died for all, then all men should be dead. And the reason he died for all was so that living men should live no longer for themselves, but for him who died and was raised to life for them. From now onwards, therefore, we do not judge anyone by the standards of the flesh. Even if we did once know Christ in the flesh, that is not how we know him now. And for anyone who is in Christ, there is a new creation. The old creation has gone, and now the new one is here. The word of the Lord. The gospel acclamation. Alleluia, alleluia. May the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ enlighten the eyes of our mind so that we can see what hope his call holds for us. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. With the coming of evening, Jesus said to his disciples, "Let us cross over to the other side." And leaving the crowd behind, they took him just as he was in the boat, and there were other boats with him. Then it began to blow a gale, and the waves were breaking into the boat so that it was almost swamped. But he was in the stern, his head on the cushion, asleep. They woke him and said to him, "Master, do you not care? We are going down." And he woke up and rebuked the wind and said to the sea, "Quiet now, be calm." And the wind dropped, and all was calm again. Then he said to them, "Why are you so frightened? How is it that you have no faith?" They were filled with awe and said to one another, "Who can this be? Even the wind and the sea obey him." The Gospel of the Lord. Jesus and his disciples are crossing to the other side of the Sea of Galilee in the evening. Jesus was tired from the day's labor and was sleeping in the boat. The Sea of Galilee is 21 kilometers long and 13 kilometers wide and is the lowest freshwater lake on earth. The main source of its water is the River Jordan, which flows from Mount Hermon. The small hills surrounding the lake inflate the beauty of the location. At the same time, the winds coming from the hills create occasional storms in the lake. Many of Jesus' disciples are fishermen from this area. It is not the first time they are venturing into the troubled waters of the sea. They are familiar with the change of weather in the lake. But this storm, wind, and Jesus sleeping at that time are meant to teach the disciples some important lessons of life. Jesus calming the sea is a clear sign of Christ's power over the negative elements in the world. It reveals his divinity, and the disciples ask, "Who can this be? Even the wind and the sea obey him." Even after seeing the many miracles of Jesus, the disciples are not strong in their faith. But Jesus has complete trust in the providence of God and can sleep peacefully in the middle of a heavy storm. The faith life of a Christian is beautifully described in this incident. The sea with the storm is an image of the troubles we face daily. The boat is our journey of life, and there are many others who are traveling along with us. We face many challenges, and sometimes solving them is beyond our control. The sleeping Jesus is also a reminder of the constant presence of God with us. Most of the time, we complain that God is not mindful of our struggles, but he might be standing next to us and may interfere when it is most needed. Believers are like the disciples, that even after experiencing many miracles, we forget that Jesus can protect us. We all have faced similar storms in our lives, where we felt the lack of God's presence when we needed it most. But after everything calms down, we realize that it was not Jesus who was absent from our lives. We were the ones who either did not realize his presence or failed to act according to his dictates. Jesus did not perform a miracle at that time to save us, actually helped us to become stronger in our faith. He continues to help us in realizing our own strength and limitations daily. The storms of life will always be there, and at the same time, the presence of Jesus is stronger than before. Today, we may have to ask Jesus to take control of our boat. Prayer is our means to make present God in our lives. Nothing can destroy us if Jesus is with us. Jesus can calm down the storm with a single word if needed. There will always be wind and storm in our journeys, but at the same time, we never forget to ask Jesus for help. Let us make the profession of our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. In today's Gospel, Jesus tells us, "Do not be afraid, have faith in me." We pray that in moments of fear, of doubt, of despair, that we recall the word of the Lord and place our trust in his love and goodness.
We pray for Pope Francis, that he be inspired by the Spirit to be a brave and trusted navigator of our church as we travel through the stormy waters which threatens it in today's troubled and hostile world. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for those refugees who have been driven by poverty, war, and racial hatred to risk their lives on stormy seas, and particularly for the thousands who have lost their lives on the journey. We pray that those of us who are blessed and have been spared these hardships should respond with the compassion which our Christian faith demands of us. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for all who work and volunteer in sea, air, and water rescue, that the trust they daily place in the Lord be rewarded. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
On today, Father's Day, we pray for all fathers that they may enjoy the love and respect of their families, and that they may be good providers for those who depend on them. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We bow our heads and remember in silence our own personal intentions and the intentions of those who have asked for our prayers. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us. We remember and pray for Brian Conlon, John and Julia McShane, Dennis and Molly Doyle, Huey and Seamus Riley, John Rafferty, his daughter Teresa, and deceased family members, Veronica Shields and Jerry Rowland, for whom this Mass is being offered, that they may be raised to everlasting life in the kingdom of heaven. Lord, hear us. We pray through the intercession of Mary as we say, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed are thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your loving help and guidance through the storms of life, and ask that we be blessed with your loving presence in this life and in your kingdom to come. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. Praying, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Receive, O Lord, the sacrifice of conciliation and praise, and grant that, cleansed by its action, we may make offering of a heart pleasing to you through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hands. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by his birth he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering cancelled out our sins. By his rising from the dead he has opened the way to eternal life, and by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so, with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Eamon and Michael, our bishops, and all the clergy. Remember your servants, Brian Conlon, John and Julia McShane, Dennis and Molly Doyle, Huey and Seamus Riley, John Rafferty, Teresa Rafferty, and deceased family members, Veronica Shields and Jerry Rowland, who whom you have called from this world to yourself, grant that they who were united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles and all the saints, Saint Brigid, who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. May this mingling of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring eternal life to us, who receive it. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my room, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. I am the good shepherd, and I lay down my life for my sheep, says the Lord. Let us pray. Renewed and nourished by the sacred body and precious blood of your Son, we ask of your mercy, O Lord, that what we celebrate with constant devotion may be our sure pledge of redemption through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever. Amen. Our Mass is ended. Let us go in the peace of Christ.